Welcome to the Shtick.
Welcome to the Shtick.
Barry, welcome everyone.
Hey, good to be back.
And welcome back to you.
Yes.
Oh my God, it's been a long time.
Yes, it has.
And let's show the audience.
Take your
let's
hand
show
off
what
your face.
Happened.
It's a
long story.
This is why I've been away.
A take by a wild animal
in bed.
In bed.
It was a, you know, actual...
You've been in hiding because all the wounds had to heal up.
Never seen him happier.
Yeah, that's exactly
right. That's the only one left.
That's exactly right. You want to see the cotton balls?
Please. Look, today we're talking about giving. Maybe that's giving too much.
I was on the receiving end.
But we are talking about giving.
We're talking about giving, and important to know when you're giving things, people will assume giving as in charity is giving money.
Yeah.
But... primarily, as with volunteering and giving of one's time, it's important that we give of ourselves, not necessarily financially, but of ourselves physically.
Which begs the question.
Yes.
When we were talking to Tom Borski a little bit beforehand, we were talking about the generations that have given, let's say, to Israel, which we talk about, that we give a lot to them.
Yes.
And the generations before us have worked tirelessly.
Yes.
Now, our generation, on the other hand, is a bit more diluted in the sense that we do give a lot of money, but what... people like Tom are saying that we need to engage ourselves more with giving.
Mm.
So the question is, what should we give more of ourselves when we live in this country, have our own lives and have a lot to do too? The only way some of us can give is money. How else do we engage?
Well, I agree that it's good financially to give. It's important to help people, talk to people, teach people. Teach by example, be in a position where just by doing something, someone is learning. And that is charity. That is giving of yourself.
Well, I think our generation, I mean, not everybody does that, but I think we've given a lot of good values to our kids. My kids, you know, they go around when something to collect blue box when they're asked to.
Yes.
You know, from Hubbo, they do all sorts of giving and they're taught all of this stuff.
Mm. Yes. I've given time and energy to my children. I think it's a very important thing.
Hasn't paid off
but
so
at the
well.
End of, at the end of the day, I think I'm just going to give them money because I think really the time, the energy, and ganzen Andreit, Gunisch gewählt, you know. And
okay, which takes us to your generation now.
Correct,
How does your generation
engage? Yeah, how do you kids...
Do you feel more diluted that you don't give enough to things like Israel and their needs?
I don't talk to my friends about charity that much. I know, and I like to do this, I volunteer for a number of things, not all of them necessarily Jewish things.
Right.
But I like to volunteer because I like to get involved with things. And
okay, which is what we're saying.
Yes,
but because we're Jewish, yes, 100% we're involved in Jewish things, but also because we live in this country,
there's
a broader community of which we also do give
to
things. Cancer councils, diabetes, all sorts of things.
Yes, correct, correct.
And there's no other way really to do that unless you become involved in all sorts of different committees and things you're physically involved
in. For example, I volunteer at the Melbourne International Film Festival.
Yeah.
And that work involves anything from ushering to picking up rubbish after the movie, going into the cinema and doing that. And that is great because you're involved with a large organisation. I love movies, so I get to see some films. And you get to make a lot of people happy by being involved with a wonderful festival. And there are countless things you can be involved with. There's museums you can volunteer for and National Trust places you can volunteer.
But if we're talking as Jews, being involved in giving to Israel, how do you and your generation give in any other way? How can you give in any other way than financially? You can't go there every 5 minutes and go volunteer in a community.
You can volunteer here for there. You can teach about what's happening. You can teach anything. It doesn't have to be specific.
Israeli dancing.
Yes.
You can do Israeli dancing.
Also good, yeah.
I've seen some of those charity cases, really.
If I may make a suggestion, let's see what the rabbi has to say, and then maybe we can take his advice and take it further from there.
Okay.
I think
we'll do that.
And welcome to this episode of The Shtick. Now, in this particular episode, we are focusing on the notion of giving, of charity, of tzedakah, of donation, taking out of yourself and giving to others. Now, historically, there has always been a great focus on giving to the needy and the underprivileged. I think enough is enough. The time has come when those who have been missing out for a long time, the privileged and the not so needy, it is their turn to be on the receiving end of charity. So I ask you, dig deep in the service of those who have everything. Give more to them. Now, take for example our show here. We on the Shtick are an impoverished show. We've got no money. We've got no support. We've got no sponsors. We've hardly got anybody who watches. And so we are desperately needy. Don't give to us. Don't give to anything behind us. Give to the big commercial networks who are like pigs in dreck, soaking up. They've got so much, they don't even know what to do with it. Give to them. It's better for a change. So this week, I ask you, think, go deep within yourself, challenge yourself, and give to those who have everything. Have a good week.
The rabbi's point about reverse psychology works very well with us. Now, I would like Barry to talk a bit more.
Well, you know, about what? About giving?
About giving.
I think charity begins at home.
Uh-huh. And this is what it is. See, yeah. Because our generation, which we have to explain,
yes.
has kids now that are in their late teens.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the amount of money that you need to spend on their schooling and their after school and everything is an absolute fortune.
Yeah.
So
mm-hmm.
when we're giving constantly, I mean, we don't have limitless, endless money. So we're constantly being pulled to give and give
all
the time.
Do you need some money? Because I've got my wallet here. Hang on a second.
I've got my wallet. The original.
I'm not going to get it out of there.
Money out of
it. I just need a few thousand. Have you got it in there?
It's really good. It's very good, this wallet. You can't
fit it in your pocket.
How much do your kids do, though?
What do you mean?
They're asking for money for activities and things.
My son works now. I mean, he goes to uni and he works part-time,
so he
has his own money, but that's not the point. If my daughter goes on a program next year for a gap year, it's going to cost $25,000 to send her for that year, which it might cost to live here.
Good luck to her that she's able to do that.
So what I'm saying...
That's not charity. That's paying for something
What I'm saying is it makes what I have less to give to everybody else, and you always feel stretched... That you always and you want to give, but how much can you give?
Things are tough now. The economy is not so good now, and you have to say. Maybe you have to say, look, I'm sorry. Please call me again next year or next time.
People,
I can't give now because I have to look after the family first. And that does come.
Well, it was very nice. I got a phone call this morning while we were actually here preparing for filming. Somebody rang up to ask for a donation for Maccabi, and they said, "Do you want to donate to Maccabi?" And I sat there for a second. I said, "Well, no." And then he said, "Oh, well, thanks and goodbye." Well, he didn't ask me, "Will you?" He asked me if I want to, and that was the answer. I don't want to.
Had he had the chutzpah, he would have said, "Will you?" And you said, "I will."
He didn't have the chutzpah enough to say, "Will you give? We need money."
He's having a bad day.
But you know, if he's a weak collector. I mean, you know, really, that's just hopeless.
But the bottom line is that everybody can afford to give all the time.
Exactly.
That's
right. That's the problem. We have to demand money back from Israel. They've got enough already.
Affluent country.
Have you seen this place? They've got canyons. Everyone's driving around in expensive cars.
BMWs, we're such a rich country that on our foreshore here, we've got one little tiny bit of beautiful decking that they've made, whereas the entire Tayelet in Tel Aviv is full. It's
exactly
hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Give us money. I can't afford a falafel and they're driving around.
Why didn't you make a charity?
What?
Why didn't you make a charity? This
exactly
is a Barry,
set up
Barry
a very charity.
Israel
UIA, United I Need Appeal.
UIA, United I Need.
It really works.
Divided we fall.
Yeah.
Well, it's all right. It's okay.
Okay.
I think, what are we going to do now?
We've made a point.
We're going out and we're back. And that's what's important.